Let's say your beloved Maine Coon ran off and bumped into a bobcat. What would happen in this case? And could your precious cat survive? Also, how do they compare in terms of size? And is it really possible the bobcat is the ancestor of the biggest domestic cat breed? Let's find out together. And go ahead and subscribe if you're into these types of videos. You love to watch them, I love to make them. We're a perfect match. Now, let's answer the burning question. Can Maine Coons come from bobcats? This is one of Maine Coons' alleged origins, so let's dive into it. From the start, I have to say it's an awesome theory. However, there's no evidence of Maine Coons descending from bobcats. This doesn't necessarily mean it's not true. So how likely is it for a bobcat to mate with cats? And could viable kittens be born? If we take a look at any wildcat's behavior, we'll notice straight away that most are solitary predators. To provide for themselves, they need to have an established territory, which means they will dearly protect it against intruders. Additionally, cats are direct competitors for bobcats, so if we take these things into account, it's much more likely for a bobcat to try to fend off any cat that's crossing its territory. However, there's also the possibility of a bobcat trying to mate with a cat. Still, the circumstances would have to be right. It would either mean for a female cat in heat to encounter a male bobcat, or vice versa. So theoretically, matings can occur between cats and bobcats. In captivity, such pairings were noticed. Still, there's no guarantee a living kitten could be born. Even if these felines can mate, there are significant genetic differences between them. It's difficult to determine if the union would produce a viable hybrid. There are no conclusive studies on this topic, and no evidence of any bobcat and domestic cat hybrid. However, we can guess by analyzing a few factors, such as size, gestational period, and studying other hybrids. A regular domestic cat is typically much smaller than a bobcat, and smaller than a Maine Coon. And if we are to believe Maine Coons descended from bobcats, it would have meant that bobcats bred with regular cats. So already there's a problem. A female bobcat in heat could see a male cat as prey due to their size difference. And if a female cat would encounter a male bobcat, there would also be a considerable size gap. But let's say mating occurs. What would happen then? Well, the gestational period for both species is approximately the same, which is great news. That being said, a newborn kitten is less than half the size of a newborn bobcat. In both cases, this would pose a serious problem. A smaller hybrid would have a less competitive advantage if born to a female bobcat. Its survival would be almost impossible since the mortality of bobcat kittens is already very high. A bigger kitten would pose problems for a mama cat at birth. Plus, many other hybrids are stillborn. Additionally, hybrid males are usually infertile until the 5th or 6th generation. So taking all these things into account, it's extremely unlikely Maine Coons come from bobcats. Sorry to disappoint you. It would have been awesome if it were true, but Maine Coons are still amazing. Let's move on and discuss how a Maine Coon compares to a bobcat in terms of appearance. Well, there are several differences between them. First of all, their coats provide the most significant clue. A bobcat's body is spotted, and its legs are striped. The bobcat can also sport rosettes, which is a rare trait in the domestic kingdom. However, a Maine Coon doesn't have either of them, no spots or rosettes. A bobcat's base color is reddish to grayish brown, while a Maine Coon can display almost every possible color. But wait, have you seen the bobcat's tail? Neither have I. Bobcats are either tailless or have small, stubbed tails. On the other hand, Maine Coons rule in this chapter. Maine Coons have incredibly long and bushy tails that would make every cat jealous. They sport the longest tails in the domestic cat kingdom. Still, Maine Coons can lack tails if they've had an accident or a genetic defect. Let's take a look at their faces. They're also pretty darn different. A bobcat's face is full of hair that flows down its cheeks and neck. Its ears are black-tipped and pointed, with short black tufts. On the other hand, a Maine Coon lacks those lateral hairs that neatly frame the bobcat's face. A Maine Coon's face fluff is much more randomly placed. Additionally, its ears aren't necessarily black-tipped, but resemble the body coloration. Last but not least, Maine Coons can either have lynx tips or not, which can be of any color. There are also some crucial behavioral differences between them. A bobcat is a highly secretive, wild feline. It will typically avoid human contact at all costs. As a result, you're unlikely to spot one. A Maine Coon, even if it's feral, will still come closer to humans than a bobcat. So next time when you think you saw a bobcat, look at its face and tail to be sure. Don't shoot it either. First of all, bobcats aren't aggressive toward people. And second of all, it might actually be a Maine Coon. Yep, Maine Coons are often mistaken for bobcats and killed. Let's talk about their sizes. Maine Coon males and females alike weigh less than bobcats. Male Maine Coons weigh between 13 and 22 pounds, while females weigh between 9 to 14 pounds. However, some males can be even heftier, weighing up to 30 pounds or more. And I'm talking about regular ones, not chubby fellows. Still, these individuals are hard to come by. So let's see how a bobcat compares. Adult males can range in weight from 14 to 40 pounds, with an average of 21 pounds. Females are smaller, averaging 15 pounds. The largest bobcat accurately measured on record weighed 49 pounds, but some reportedly reached 60 pounds. So even if we take the average numbers into account, bobcats are typically bigger than Maine Coons, but not by much. However, a big bobcat can be twice the size of a Maine Coon, putting the latter at a clear disadvantage. And now, let's learn if a Maine Coon could survive a bobcat attack. It's challenging to say. Bobcats are usually larger than Maine Coons, so here are the necessary conditions for a Maine Coon to survive. The Maine Coon would need to be large enough. Basically, the difference in size between the two felines should be little to none. If the bobcat is considerably larger, the Maine Coon will most likely not stand a chance. The Maine Coon should be aware of the bobcat's presence and should not be taken by surprise. I assume any Maine Coon can detect another feline if it's not deeply asleep and doesn't have visual or hearing problems. Still, the Maine Coon shouldn't be super friendly with other cats. If your Maine Coon is territorial, it has a higher chance of survival. The Maine Coon should be confident in defending itself. If your Maine Coon is easily scared, things won't go well for him. That being said, bobcats seldom attack cats, which is reassuring to know. This might be for several reasons. The bobcat isn't used to seeing a cat and doesn't know how dangerous the cat is. The bobcat realizes the cat is a feline and knows it has claws. A severe injury would prevent the bobcat from hunting, which would lead to its starvation. Predators tend to avoid dangerous prey. Cats can also sense bobcats and will most likely avoid them in the first place. If a bobcat spots an animal larger than its usual prey, it likely won't attack unless it's starving and desperate. Plus, if a fight occurs but doesn't go well, the bobcat will be less likely to attack a Maine Coon again. If it's the bobcat's mating season, then a Maine Coon of a different sex might not be attacked, but one of the same sex can. Either way, serious wounds on both sides are highly likely, especially for the Maine Coon. So overall, a Maine Coon could survive a bobcat attack if the right conditions are met. Otherwise, its chances would be pretty slim. A Maine Coon could manage to drive the predator away by hissing, spitting, and fighting. That being said, a Maine Coon has a very low chance of killing a bobcat. It might happen if the bobcat is young and small. But a bobcat attacking a cat is pretty rare in the first place, so that's great. Still, I wouldn't advise letting your cat roam freely, as there are plenty of dangers outside for such a small animal. I really loved making this video. It was fascinating to learn about the differences between a bobcat and a Maine Coon. If you enjoyed it too, give it a like and check out my channel for more exciting videos. I've also created a list of some fantastic services and products for your cat. It's in the description. Feel free to look through it. By the way, check out my t-shirt design, Maine Coon the King, a tribute to this magnificent breed. Thanks for watching, and see ya in my next video.